Hi, my name is Mike Granato. My good buddy, Shaun Webb. We're with Athletic Motion Golf. Shaun, we give a lot of beginner lessons, and we see them do things throughout the swing just from inexperience, basically, or so maybe something they've heard and kind of misinterpreted that really kind of gets them going down the wrong roads with regards to their golf swing. So we're going to take a look at each part of the golf swing and give you some really key tips that are going to really kind of get you back on track and make picking up this game and staying in this game that much more fun and that much more enjoyable. Shaun, so we got to start with a setup in the golf swing, right? Yeah. And I think that's really where we see probably the most offensive from new golfers. Yeah. Offense?
Yes. Flags. Throw flags.
Red flags.
Yeah. Yellow flag.
Most violations from beginning golfers. And, you know, most of us, when we take up the game, we'll go maybe get some secondhand clubs or borrow our parents' clubs and go out, grab it, and just start swinging.
Yeah.
And we really haven't developed kind of some key principles that make swinging the golf club easier.
Yeah, and you know, the grip, that's another whole 10-minute video in itself. So right. If you haven't
done it,
you'll watch that. So the first thing I'm going to say is, as far as setup, and this is probably the main thing, golfers don't know how to hinge properly from their hips.
Right.
Right. They just, A, haven't been taught, or B, it doesn't feel good at first. They just want to grab the club, just kind of lower themselves in any way
right.
to get to the ball, and it creates this kind of motion, which is, you know, that's a common beginner motion.
Yeah, absolutely.
So, you know, here's a good way to get in the correct setup if you're a beginner golfer, or even aren't a beginner, but this will help you a lot. Put the club across your waist, mm-hmm. right? Keep your legs completely straight. Bend forward from the hips. You feel like your hips are going to push back just a little just to mm-hmm. counter you, right? Bend forward till your fingertips are around your kneecaps, and just crack your knees and kind of sink into the ground and feel your weight of your body into the ground. Then just let your arms hang. You're going to end up with a pretty neutral lower back if you do that. You're not going to be super rounded,
right.
And your rear end, you've been told to stick your rear end out. You don't need to do that either because it creates a huge arch. So very natural, bend forward from the hips, crack your knees. If I just let my arms hang, that gives me a pretty good chance to set up correctly and start swinging my arms around my body.
Yeah, I think one of the red flags with this would be, we see golfers a lot of times who I've actually seen them do this in lessons, will kind of set up, square themselves up, you know, down their target line, use this, and then push this shaft back where it gets them. Their toes pop up in the air like this, and then they think that's a golf posture. And yeah. then as soon as they start moving the club,
yeah,
it's early extension city, just right early in the backswing.
Absolutely.
So I like the idea of kind of keeping this here and bending forward on top of the shaft yeah. rather than pushing the shaft
yeah.
back and away.
I always say, you know, feel like you're bending over a fence, and you don't, it doesn't have to go back very far to do that, right? You have to go a little bit or you're gonna fall over.
Right.
But just a little bit this way, bend from the hips. Now you've got some angle from your torso to your legs.
Right.
And that's what you're looking for to start making this pivot.
And really pay attention of where your weight is, where your pressure is in your feet when you're doing this. So again, if you go back like this, that pops
yeah,
my toes up.
That's a good point.
As soon as I start moving, I'm gonna be hunting for balance. If I do like Shaun suggested, boom, I feel like my pressure is right underneath where I tie my shoes. And that's really where you wanna be. That lets me move left to right, offset the forces,
yeah.
Put on the body when the club starts swinging around you. And it's yes. really going to give you a solid foundation for when you start moving. Because out on the golf course, uneven lies, below your feet, above your feet, all that, you don't want to be starting with a bias into the heels or even out in the toes.
Yeah, and video yourself from down the line or have your friend take a picture. If you look like your legs are about to slide under a table and you're about to eat or work
right.
at your computer, that's not correct. And again, you don't want to, like Mike said, you don't want your rear end is so far behind your heels that now you're forced to make this
right.
motion. So we want a neutral ground with the posture so the body can move naturally.
Yeah, this is just as bad, back straight, kind of like you said, sliding under the table, a nice slope to the back,
yeah.
rear end a little bit behind
yeah,
you.
Yeah, and they're not, his rear end is not very far behind his heels. You know, push it
right.
push it back a lot. That's what we see a lot of people doing, and now, like Mike said, you're gonna extend
your body. As soon as you move,
body.
You're coming out of that posture.
Yeah.
And if you're a beginner golfer, or even a golfer who's been playing a long time, you've heard to maintain your posture, and that's one of the fastest ways to lose your posture, is to set up really essentially out of balance, and then as soon as you start moving, you have to kind of get in an athletic spot.
And you know, just real quick, backtrack for a second as far as the grip, real quick. You know, those of you that set up with very straight upright, up and yep. down. You can't get your hand on there correctly anyway because it needs to be in the fingers more. It's very hard to crank your hand around that way. So
you just start holding it like a putter.
Yeah, these things all work together. So that gives you some good tips as far as the setup is concerned right. to get you going on the right track.
Now let's talk about the next phase of the swing. All right, Sean, now let's talk about the backswing. And this is where either good setup or bad setup, this is where we see a lot of things start to go off the track. And your golf swing, right? Just about everyone's golf swing from the moment you take that club back till you strike the ball lasts just 1 second.
Yeah.
And at this spot in the backswing, this left arm parallel in the backswing, half of that 1 second is gone. And if you're moving this club in a really bad way, or a way that's going to affect that last half a second, then the whole downswing is spent trying to undo stuff. And it's really not a way you want to start playing the game.
No, he's absolutely right. So the game is hard, in my opinion, because it's static setup position.
Right.
There's nothing moving, right? It's not baseball where the ball is coming at you and you stay in constant motion. Once you get your setup, it's just you and the ball. Things not going anywhere. So I think that in of itself creates all these really bad kind of golf motions that you see,
right?
Because they don't
right.
know how to get things moving. So what I want you to do, and the tip I want you to take here for the backswing, is that you need to feel a swinging backswing.
Yes.
And you know, I've taught that for a lot of years because I feel like it gets people to have motion in the backswing and instead of trying to just find where the club goes, because everybody's seen a still shot of the top of a backswing that looks like this. And what a lot of people do, just try to place the club there.
Mm-hmm.
But that takes away all the motion that created that top of the backswing.
Motion begets motion, right?
Exactly right.
So going to your point, to start the club first, you're starting it with your feet. Mm-hmm. You're starting it kind of rocking the feet back and forth a little bit. And from face on, it's kind of like, you know, I'm mm-hmm. creating motion here to get this club in motion. And then the body just does so many things naturally when you let it.
Yeah, so a way to feel this, right?
Yes.
And you can even hit balls like this, is to start the club in front of the ball about 2 feet. Don't push your hands over there, just swing the club in front of you.
Right.
Swing it back and let the body catch up to that motion, and you'll marry it up where they finish at about the same time at the top of the swing.
We're actually using the arms and club, getting those swinging first and then letting kind of the pivot, so to speak, let the pivot kind of catch all that and get to the top at basically the same time. And what's one of the key offenders of that is this kind of pivot-driven backswing.
Yeah, so you see two backswings with beginners, a body-driven backswing
right.
and just an arm chop, right? If you get this club swinging, it's a lot more intuitive, especially if you have good posture like we just talked about. If I can get this club swinging and then just marry in the body, it's amazing how well this club swings up to the top and gets you in a position to move on the downswing.
That's exactly right. So again, we want to create motion with the feet, right? Don't plant your feet in concrete, right? Mm-hmm. They're going to need to move throughout the golf swing. So go ahead and get them moving, get some life to this club head.
Mm-hmm.
And then once this thing starts getting kind of past this 45 degrees to the ground, the turn's going to kind of kick in and support it to let it go on up to the top of the swing. If you can do that and do it to where it becomes so easy and natural and you're just kind of standing around swinging the club,
yeah.
you're going to be on top of that good setup.
Yeah,
you're going to be so far ahead of the game relative to beginners that you're really going to progress and start shooting lower scores much, much faster.
Yeah, and I'm going to give Mike one more way to help someone with this. So okay. go ahead and set up to this ball.
Okay.
So I've seen this drill a lot and I've used it a lot. You know, if you're with your buddy or they're with you, have them go ahead and set up to the ball.
Okay.
Have them kind of swing the club away for you.
Oh, yeah. Do that again.
Get the club in motion. So just have them kind of lightly push it away. And what you'll find is that this club starts to feel kind of light and the body responds to that motion. So
yeah.
get the club swinging early. That's the best tip I can give you for the backswing.
That's exactly right. All right, now let's go on to the next step. All right, Sean, we've got really good setup now, really athletic setup. We've got some motion created downstairs in the feet. Got the club swinging now, the body starting to engage. We're getting to the top in a really good spot.
Yeah,
now what? We haven't hit the ball yet, now what?
So I've given a lot of lessons over the years and you know, you meet people, you tell them what you do for a living and you know, they tell you, oh, I sliced the ball.
Right.
And it's like, well, give me one thing to help me slice. Well, usually it's this tip I'm about to give you, right? So I'm gonna go up to the top of the swing And Mike is going to come in here and hold me where I can't turn on the downswing.
Yeah, so I'm going to really kind of lock his shoulders in place here.
So I'll do this to a lot of students and tell them to swing down, and Mike's going to hold me, and they'll go, and they cannot move.
Yeah, right? Exactly right.
So that shows me how upper body dominant their downswing is, which is, that's the slice.
They're attaching, bringing the club down with making some sort of a body move to bring the club down.
Okay, so I'm going to do that again, and I'll have the student hold me usually, and I'll just go like this. I could actually hit the ball like this, yeah, right? And that changes in their mind. Usually a light bulb will go off. It's like, oh, I need some freedom in my arms. Again, the body's responding. You know, I feel like most people are really have this body-driven or upper body-driven downswing motion, which gets the club steep and slicing. But if they can get some freedom in the arms and have the body support it, it's amazing how much more effortless this feels and how much more in plane the club swings.
It's so funny you mentioned that, because at the Honda Classic this year, I had two gentlemen when watching, on Thursday watching the tournament, and they come up to me and recognized the hat or whatever and came up and said, you know, hey, appreciate all your videos, this and that. Can you take a look at my swing? Tell me what you think.
Yeah, exactly.
And two of the three guys did exactly that. Got to the top. They said, I just can't stop coming over the top. And it was like the arms are in a cast, and the only way you can move this club is to do this or do this.
Yeah.
Right?
Absolutely.
And depending on what level you are, you're going to do one of the two. And did the exact same thing. Hold their shoulders, let them feel the arm swing, and then the light bulb goes off, and they go, that's what I see these guys doing.
Mm-hmm.
So
exactly
it's
right.
Really that kind of same feeling of getting the club moving first in the backswing. It's the same thing from the downswing. It's really getting this motion. Now, it's not, you're not going to look like this.
No, nobody does
that.
The
turn's going to catch it.
Yeah.
But it's going to be so synced up, and you're going to approach the ball from way more on the inside instead of way on the outside.
No, 100% correct. And, you know, the great thing about that is it feels so much more free. Right?
Yes.
It feels like you can generate some speed, and you're not so locked up always and wiping across the ball. But getting some motion in the arms is a great way to start feeling the beginning of this downswing.
Well, and as you stay in the game and as you progress through the game, you're going to start hearing things about rotation at impact, being open at impact. And if you tie these arms and chest together when you start down, you're going to have to stop all this rotation to try to hit the golf ball.
Yeah.
If you get the arms swinging down into this thing, we'll call it the slot for lack of a better term, and then turn, you're going to be encouraged to really turn through the shot and get that nice rotation and impact.
Yeah, and we're not saying there's no body motion in the transition, because there is.
There absolutely is.
The hips are going to start a little bit early, but the majority of golfers that are beginners start with this big upper body motion.
Yes.
And that's what we're trying to eliminate here.
And you can try to be, Jason Kokrak's a great example, you could try to be arms dominant as much as you want, the body is still going to help you do that.
Yeah.
And that's what we're trying to do, is find that balance. It's way over indexed towards that hit impulse, because the chest and shoulders feel stronger.
And rotate. Right? That's what you hear in the marketplace.
But it's getting this synced up, it's getting these arms involved first, really, that allows this body to work better.
Absolutely.
So now let's go to the final piece, which is the moment of truth. Sean, so we've got our setup dialed in, right? We're athletic. We've got the club head moving, body catching it up here at the top. Now we've got the arms and body moving in sequence now in the downswing. Now, what's a great tip for beginner golfers to really lock down and start to feel that really good golfer impact?
Yeah, and you know, this one is difficult for a lot of golfers, because they again read a lot of conflicting advice and watch videos that they need a lot of shaft lean. And for beginning golfers, I think the best way to think about impact is learn how to brush the ground with the bottom of the club.
Yeah.
I mean, it seems so basic, but when you start thinking about shaft lean and shoving the hands ahead, most of the time, that's what the beginning golfer is going to do, is drive the club into the ground.
To start getting that body dominated, really steep downswing, and it's just going to send you, it's going to retard your progress in some cases for years or even decades.
Here's
you see it all the time.
Yeah, absolutely. Here's the best piece of advice I can ever give you as a beginner. Learn how to clip the tee. I laid a tee flat on the ground here. I just took a normal tee and laid it flat.
Yep.
And the progression of this is start with your feet together and learn how to clip that tee off the ground without digging the club deep into the ground. And I just made a little tiny clip there, that tee got up in the air. Once you can do that a few times, get your feet shoulder width apart, swing the club back, swing it through, clip the ground, and just go to your right toe. And marry your arms and your body together. And I didn't do a very good job there, I would chunk that one. So I'm gonna do it one more time.
And this is what you're gonna do. You're gonna hit behind it. You may miss it on top of it.
That was perfect there. So, you know, you're learning a lot with this drill, although you don't think you are.
Yeah.
You're learning how to ground the club in the right spot, but not only that, it has to be coming in at a shallow angle to clip this tee in the right spot, or you're gonna drive it right into the ground.
You're learning the timing of the downswing. You're learning of swinging through it
rather than trying to hit at it.
You're learning kind of letting the club get the thing airborne. Because if you try to scoop hitting this tee, it's gonna be very difficult to do. You might miss it completely.
Yeah, taught so many golfers to get better at golf just by literally learning this right here and then marrying that into that motion where you just let the foot come up.
That's exactly right. And the great Harvey Pienick,
all-time
golf instructor, would have guys just go in their backyard, pick a weed, and just spend hours until they couldn't miss that same spot. It's essentially what you're doing here. You want to be able to take that setup, that backswing and that transition, and develop that those motions into this consistent spot. If you want a skill in golf that you can work on right now, it's hit the ground in the same spot every time.
Yeah.
And it's always going to benefit you. You're going to draw on that for the rest of the time you play golf.
It'll pay dividends just by learning that.
Yep.
Just by getting good at brushing the ground with the sole of the club in the right spot. It's going to help every part of your game.
Yep.
You're going to get better right away.
And you're going to benefit from that long after you're out of this beginner stage into your tour days. So let us know what you think. If you've tried these drills, let us know. We'd love to hear your comments. If you haven't, give them a try. Then let us know how they went. We'll make more videos to help you out. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please give us a thumbs up by clicking that like button. If you have a comment about the video, please share it with us. We read every comment. We want to answer them. We want to make this information as clear as possible. Sometimes we don't do it in the video. We can clear it up in the comments below. Also, if we haven't covered a topic that can help your game, please let us know that as well. We'll make a video just for you. And as always, if you haven't subscribed, please do. You'll get a notification every time a new video comes out. Now, if you're a guy or a girl who could use more tour-like impact, compression, all those cool words we see every week on the PGA Tour, cracking those irons off the face, we've put together a free video with our number one drill to give you all of those things in your swing, and you're gonna do it just as soon as you watch that video. All you need to do is go to the first pinned comment below. There's a link in that comment. Click on that link, be taken to a page where you enter your email name. We're gonna send that video, that free video, straight to your inbox immediately so you can get cracking on those iron shots for more compression, more distance, and more fun out there on the golf course.